That was probably the worst thing difficult. I've seen ever in my life.
That was very difficult.
Let me see your mustache.
First run. Oh. All right, today we're going to talk about my EDC backpack.
It's where I keep all my things. I get a lot of compliments on this. Plus, it's not a man purse. It's called a satchel.
What I choose to use, this is the Mountainsmith Divide. It's a laptop backpack. I think it runs anywhere from about $60 to about $80 on Amazon and on their website. It does have a dedicated laptop sleeve, which is the full size of the pack. It's about a 10 by 16 pocket, so you should be able to fit anything 17 inch, probably even a little larger if they make laptops that are like that. But we're just going to break it down from the outside to inside to what I keep in an EDC backpack, what's important, both from a tactical standpoint with protection and reloads, as well as convenient stuff such as a knife sharpener, battery pack, water, just things that you could use every day and you do use every day. First of all, my priority with this backpack, I was looking for one that had a good setup that I could put a body armor panel in. So for me, I do this little side laptop sleeve. There is an additional laptop sleeve on the inside. This is where I choose to put my body armor panel. This is a 10 by 16 panel, which you can see is about the full size of this pack. Pretty much fits the entire silhouette very well. 10 by 16, it's by Armor Unlimited. It's one current and one former sergeant in some sort of Arizona police department. They just wanted it more affordable. This only runs about $84, which for a 10 by 16 level 3A panel, it's pretty solid. It'll stop almost all handgun threats. I imagine if you had something like a 5.7, it might would sneak through just a little higher velocity. But your typical 9mm, 40, 45, 357, anything like that's gonna get stopped by this panel. It is the full size of the pack, and it's actually more than the cost of the pack. But it's worth having, and it's good for 5 years NIJ rating. Probably the most accessed thing in my backpack is my water. This is a 32 ounce Nalgene. Ever since I upgraded from a sling pack to a backpack and I started carrying a bag that has a water bottle, 32 ounces, it's no slouch. I've started drinking a lot more water. Over here on this side is a tool pouch, something I've used numerous times on the range. Had a buddy whose magwell, he bought an Amazon knockoff of a Zev magwell. It's actually Clint, he's on the channel. And he didn't have the tool to take it off when he realized his mags weren't seating. So all we did is just pop this out. Turns out I had an Allen bit, not a wrench, but an Allen bit that fit his mag well, and we were able to take that off and he could just use his Gen 3 as is. Just a basic setup, not gonna go over the whole toolkit, but I do have a mini ratchet with a bit set for it. I have two standard Phillips, two flat, three Torx and two Allen, I believe. Then I have a adjustable spanner. Then I've got some duct tape, a bit extender for my ratchet set, as well as an AR-15 bolt scraper. Not that I use an AR-15 bolt scraper every day, but I lost this for about 2 months. Once I found it, I was like, I'm gonna put it somewhere that I know where it is. Over here, I got the Gerber Dime, just a mini multi-tool. I just wanted something that would have pliers on them, just for pulling at 550, random things on the bag, as well as things at work, shoelaces, anything with the aglets. Just, it's nice to have a small set of pliers. I do have a set of fingernail clippers. Do have some super glue. Not 100% sure about keeping this in here. I have had one where it started to leak, but I got to it before it ruined any of the elastic or the nylon on the inside. In the back here, I do have a screw pop utility knife. It is magnetic, and I'll give you some close-ups on this. It is magnetic, so there's no rattle. It keeps it closed. You don't have to worry about it. It's a nice utility blade so that you don't have to worry about sort of beating up your everyday carry knife. You can just use a utility knife. And right here, I do have a set of 5 extra blades for it. In the back here, just a simple paper notebook. I do have a pen further on the inside of the pack. I had one in here, but it was actually about the same height as this. So it was, I was having some problems where it would click in every once in a while, and I just didn't want to deal with that issues or ink leaking or anything like that. So I kind of moved the pen. Back here is just a simple Night Ice pry bar and a handcuff key. And I would swear when they were designing this pack, they designed it exactly for this Maxpedition microbe because it fits in this side pouch like a glove. Another frequently accessed thing, reach for the wrong side. I do keep two little neck gaiter, face mask type things in here. Partially because anytime you want to go in a gas station now, you have to have a mask on you, as well as if there's any sort of situation where there's, you know, a lot of ash or dirt or debris, if I'm riding windows down at the farm, anything like that. Sometimes it's just nice to have one of these really breathable neck gaiters. I believe these are for fishing, so they're not really that warm, but if you put it around your neck, it is a little something extra for when it gets cold. In this front, I also have an electronics pouch. As you can tell, I kind of like the Maxpeditions. The heart and soul of this pack is a 10,000 milliamp battery, which does take USB-C or USB in ports, as well as it has a USB full-size export. 10,000 is about the size of a credit card, but quite thick. 10,000 milliamps is enough to where I could probably go on a 3-day, 2-night vacation, or if I'm going to visit parents or something like that, I don't have to worry about bringing a super long cable because I can just charge it using this and then recharge it when I get back home. I do have two USB-Cs, two USBs, just because those are my two most frequent used, as well as, you know, I've got buddies that also have Androids that take USB-C, as well as I believe the iPhones might be taking them these days. So it's just nice to have multiple USB-Cs and then USBs for things like the camera light or earbuds, anything like that. I have this Olight charger, which is nice. I carry the Olight S2R baton, which has a little magnetic tail cap for recharging. It's just nice to have that in case my flashlight dies, as well as the USB-C one to recharge my phone so that even if it dies and this stops working for some reason, I still have a phone light. I also have the lightning cable for an iPhone because my lady friend still has an iPhone 8, I believe, which takes the lightning port. It doesn't have the upgraded new USB-C or whatever iPhone went to. Back here underneath the battery bank, I also keep a little wall brick, which is extremely thin, fits nice at the bottom of the pack, and it has two USB out ports. Extremely convenient because I can charge my battery bank and my phone at the same time. Then on the other side, behind my chargers, I keep four. These are Surefire brand, but they're CR123s because in a pinch, my S2R, I can take out the rechargeable battery. It'll work on two CR123s, as well as my weapon light, which is a TLR7A, takes one CR123 battery, as well as if I have a truck gun or if I'm going hunting, all of my weapon lights also can accept CR123 batteries, either one or two batteries at a time. So I just like to keep this topped off, carry four batteries with me. Surefire, Streamlight are my go-tos. You can usually get about 12 batteries for 20 bucks, something like that. Next thing I keep accessible in this front is a 33-round Glock stick mag.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
This is actually a KCI Gen 2. It is not a Glock mag because I am a poor and I am currently trying to close on a house and I really wanted some 33-round mags. Just upgraded from the Magpul 27 rounds. Just because of the size of this pack, the 33 fits when it's fully loaded. It just sits right in place, perfect in the middle, and it's right at the zipper level so I can just unzip, reach in, and then I have a pretty good purchase on this magazine. 33 rounds, is it excessive? A little bit, but it's in a backpack and I'm carrying it with two shoulders, so who cares? Next up in here, just in case, just keep a little bit of a paracord. This is probably only about 10 feet, but it's enough to where if I have to rig some sort of shelter or even if I want to fix some of the zippers or something like that on this pack, if they were to break, which none of them have, got some paracord. Also takes up very little space. I just stuff it in at the bottom of the pack and it's a backpack. So you've got 20 liters of space. So why not? These are my old gloves. They're just some simple mechanics, fast fits. They run about 12 bucks. I got some new gloves, so these became the dedicated bag gloves. They still have some of that faux leather. It's pretty good surface, just in case I have to do any sort of work with wood or anything that might be splintery or just something that's a little gross and I don't want to touch it direct hand to object. It's nice to have some good work gloves. Last thing I keep in this little front pouch is just a little, let's see, what brand is this even? It's just a Rapala knife sharpener. It's pretty much the Walmart brand, but it's about $3. And if your blade gets to that point where it's extremely, extremely dull, you at least have two sides that you can give it a quick hone. It's not gonna be Benchmade quality or anything like that, but it's a decent little knife sharpener and it takes up very little space. So that's it for the front pouch. Now let's go into the main compartment. So in here, and I'll show you an overhead view of what I see, I basically see three items in the main compartment, which is a boo-boo kit, a trauma kit, and a Cat Gen 7 tourniquet. We'll get to that in a minute. In this pouch right here, which is probably meant for sunglasses, between these two little pouches, I keep some wireless Bluetooth earbuds. These are pretty excellent. They're Tautronics. They're not the best. I have had occasionally where they won't turn on. They won't connect, I'll say. They'll turn on. They won't connect immediately when I open the case. Usually the solution to that is just hit it with a quick USB-C once it gets like that little bit of charge. For some reason, that completely resets them. You open it, they'll connect. It's fine. I've only had that happen twice, and I've had these for about 4 or 5 months, but they hold their charge. I've gotten 5 or more uses where it says battery low. Throw it back in here, charge it up. I tend to use one earbud at a time. One, so I can hear things, and two, you're using half the battery of the pack. So that's what I keep in there. Now behind it, because I like to smoke cigars pretty frequently, I keep a toothbrush and toothpaste, just a little mini one. It's just nice to not have the lady complain that you smell like smoke when you come home. Then, because I still play Army, I do keep a razor just in case I forget to shave. I don't have to shave except on Army weekends, so very frequently I'll forget to shave the morning of, so I just keep a razor just in case. As well as sometimes it's nice to hit the neck just so that the beard doesn't look worse than it already does. So that's what I keep in that top little sunglasses pouch. Not a clamshell, so it's hard to show you, but I'll give you a top view. Like I said, I do keep a Sharpie as well as a Zebra stainless steel pen. I believe it's F701. Yeah, F701 and a Sharpie. Just some sort of writing utensils. The Sharpie can go on pretty much anything. Stainless steel pen just pairs with that little paper in case I do have to write something, or if I have to sign something, I just want to use my own really sturdy pen. You know, closing on a house, signing a lot of documents. It's nice to just have something that feels substantial. Now, those three things I was talking about earlier were the boo-boo kit, a mini trauma kit, and a cap tourniquet. This is the Gen 7 with the gray label. First, let's get into the boo-boo kit because there's a lot to go over. This is just some Amazon first aid kit, but I've mostly filled it out to make it my own. I had a few good things like Band-Aids and a triangle bandage. Other than that, pretty much everything in here I just kind of threw in to add to it. First, it does have a little mini set of shears. Not really good for much. I've used shears in a medical emergency, and wouldn't cut through the bottom little elastic band of a hoodie because it kept stretching around the blade. Cheap things like this aren't good for much, but this is good for like cutting galls or something if you're trying to be a little neat, so I keep it in here. Like I said, triangle bandage. Do have some extra gloves, plenty of triple antibiotic ointment. I also keep an extra Neosporin, so just in case I run out of the little individuals, I still have something. Got a whistle. Not really a first aid thing for me, but if this first aid is also adding to sort of a survival aspect, similar to the reasons I keep paracord around, you do have that little whistle just in case. As well as I keep this little implement, which is just some iodine tablets. This is 50. I believe 2 tablets will purify 32 ounces or 1 quart, which is what I have my Nalgene for. So I can purify Nalgene 25 times with this, drinking unsanitary water. So I like to keep that as for a survival aspect as well. I do keep Tylenol as well as ibuprofen just for random aches and pains, friends that have headaches and kind of stuff. As you become an adult, your friends have aches and pains, so it's nice to be the mom that can give them what they need. Other than that, just have some sterile alcohol pads, Q-tips, a little bit of medical tape. It's really about all you need for a basic boo-boo kit. There's plenty of Band-Aids in here as well, so those random cuts on your fingers, you can Band-Aid it shut. If it goes really deep, I can use the glue for my toolkit. One thing I did forget to mention, I do keep this little anti-itch afterbite stick. It's about $4. I picked it up because, it's October, so just about a month ago in September, temperatures were cooling off, insects were out, but it was still warm enough, and I was getting lit up at night, so I was just really in need of an afterbite stick. As far as the trauma kit, I'm not going to open it up. I'll get into it a later video. I just don't feel like packing everything back in there. Basically, what I keep in here is a SWAT T tourniquet, which is just really stretchy rubber. Kind of hard to self-apply, but you can still do it. SWAT T tourniquet. I keep a 4-inch Israeli bandage, compression bandage. I keep 2 strips of gauze, I believe 4-inch by 40-inch, something like that. Decent enough for wound packing, as well as just wrapping simple cuts and whatnot. I also keep a hemostatic agent, some C-locks in here. I keep two compact chest seals. I believe they're like 4.5 by 5 inches or something like that. You do have to crinkle the edges just a bit, but they are still functional, as well as an extra set of gloves and a CPR one-way valve sticker kind of that you can put over the mouth. You can do CPR without worrying about any sort of fluids or nasty bacteria filled air from their lungs coming back into yours. Lastly, I do keep an NPA in here, a nasal pharyngeal airway, just in case they're having some sort of obstruction issues with their breathing. You can throw that into a nostril. I'm not gonna instruct you on how to do that because I'm not an instructor, but I will tell you they are useful. Catgen 7 tourniquet, I don't really keep it staged other than where I can just peel this red tab, open it up and slide it on. This rubber band would be in the way, but just the way I pack it in here, I know how it's staged. And that's pretty much the most important thing. I can still get to it really quickly. It might add 2 seconds, but that's just how I have to keep it staged to keep it in my pack. Getting down to the short rows. So I do keep a pair of socks. These are actually just N1. Nothing special about them, but they are nice and soft. They do cover the ankle. They're tall enough to wear in boots, but they're low enough that I can wear with shoes. This is just nice because I've definitely had wet shoes on a hike or wet shoes at work, anything like that. This is just, it's a lifesaver. Last thing I keep in this little kind of clear but has mesh behind it pouch, keep a cigar cutter. This is just a simple Jetline guillotine cutter. Works for pretty much all cigars. And I keep a Zippo. Now this one is butane, so there's no striker. It's hard to see that tiny little blue flame. It is the single torch because it is extremely efficient. I hardly ever have to change out the butane. Last thing I keep in this main pouch, I believe this is just American Eagle. It's an old OD green rain jacket I have. I like it because it's OD green. It kind of blends in, it looks normal, and it keeps rain off of me. It also packs and puffs up the bottom of this pack a little bit so that it stands up, which kind of surprised it's standing up on its own, but it doesn't have the weight of all my phone stuff. But I keep this at the bottom. It's what all my first aid stuff sits in, and it helps it sit up nice. So as far as EDC packs, comment there's anything you feel like I'm missing out. I've been carrying these exact supplies for about a month now in this pack for about 2 to 3, 4 months, somewhere in there. So I'm pretty comfortable with what I have. I don't think there's too much that I could carry without getting too oversized. Even when I carry all this, there's still a sizable portion. So if I wanted to carry my pipe bag or a cigar travel case, I can, as well as if something hits the fan, I can get to my vehicle, which has two more handgun mags. I do keep a rifle mag in there. As well as a larger IFAC. So if there's some sort of medical crisis, I could add, in addition to my boo-boo kit and trauma kit, I could add my vehicle's trauma kit. So I leave that extra space just to make it modular. So if I need ammo, I have ammo. If I need medical, I have medical. If I need more electronics, I have a battery bank with solar capabilities. So just leave that extra space so that whatever my need is, if I run into something that I can't take care of with this bag, I have the space to throw that extra materials into my bag, and then this bag is fully equipped. That being said, if there's something you feel I'm missing, comment in the comment section below. Just let me know what you think I could upgrade, as well as what you think I could add to something you think I'm carrying that's kind of ridiculous. Whatever it may be, just comment below. Thanks for watching.
What you've just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.